Okay, so this is the Revell scale 1 to 48 PT-17 Kaydet Stearman. Stearman Kaydet. It's a training plane from the Second World War, US Army. And those are all the pieces there. So, and there's the instructions. So, yeah, we're just going to go ahead and get started on this now. We've got some paints as well, and tonight we're just gonna go and do the first little bits, which is just the seats, and I think that's them there, that one and that one. So yeah, so here we go. Oh, there's Lela. She's gonna be doing the painting. So yeah, she can't find her paintbrushes. Anyway, we'll sort something out. I'm sure we'll find some somewhere.
Who are you sending this to?
This is for the YouTube video on how to make this plane.
Oh, hi guys. To all my subscribers.
Yeah, just click the like button down there somewhere. And don't forget to...
Notification bell, special like, and comment.
Yeah. Okay, Layla's been looking forward to this.
No,
oh, don't worry. I'm not gonna put this on the video.
Okay, good.
Okay, come and sit down. And
why are you still filming then?
just for fun. Okay, here we go.
So I can't find my brushes, so we're just gonna be finger painting.
Okay, by the way, everyone, so there are two different models that we could choose from here. We've got this Stearman P-17 Kaydet Airworthy Germany 2015, whatever that means. That's the yellow one. So that's 32 and 32A. And then we've got this one, which is Stearman PT-17 Kaydet U.S. Army Air Corps 1941, which I suppose, I guess, is the one that we want to be doing, you know. Since that's probably the historically more accurate one, and that's going to look like this. So yeah, just wanted to say that's the one we're doing. Okay, so the first thing that we're doing here is basically removing these pieces only partially from the plastic before painting them. So that's just to allow us to paint more of the surfaces that need painting without those plastic injection molding parts getting in the way. So we've already done that for some other pieces, those ones there and this one. You see we've cut all these bits off here, and now we're just doing the wheels. Okay, and then we'll start painting. Bit of filing there to file off those, smooth out the places where the injection molding was cut off. It's very good. Yeah, that'll make it much easier to paint. Okay, so we're now painting. Okay, it's a quick update. So we've painted the first two colors. It's this khaki green color here and the black. Most of the pieces we painted while they were still connected to the frame, we sort of removed all of the connection points here, except for one, usually, like here, and two for this frame, and picked the connection points that would be less visible in the final model. So here they're on the bottom. We cut all these ones off on top, here, here, and here's some pieces that I actually already painted and then cut out this morning. This morning I gave everything a second coat, so that's already got two coats on it, and so do all these pieces, because the first coat just lets a little bit too much of the yellow through. There's some more here as well. These are the I guess instrument panels. So that's nice and solid. There's another frame piece over here. That's for the front. So yeah, so we're just waiting for the second coat to dry now, and then we're gonna actually start assembling the internal frame structure, the cage of the fuselage. Okay, so we've cut out most of those pieces now and made sure that they've had two coats, all except for the seats, which only have one coat, but we'll do the second coat when they're glued in. And here we have the frame of the fuselage. That's pretty much all done as well. And now we're just getting ready for cutting out these main fuselage hull pieces to paint them on the inside with gray. And we're going to get a whole bunch of other pieces ready as well, because we're going to do these colors now. So they all need to be, you know, partially cut out so that they're just basically connected on one tab, just like you can see here with that one. So we can basically access this all the way around. Okay, so we are just going to go and paint the top sides of the seeds here. You can see we've glued those seats in, stick shifts are there. We've already glued painted the backs and the bottoms, because that would have been difficult to get to. And there's the parachute as well, which is painted and glued on. So yeah, so this is getting ready now to basically finish this assembly, which is going to happen fairly soon. Okay, so kind of a major step here. We're finally going to put together the frame for the main fuselage of the plane. So this has been quite a bit of work here. You can see the detail. You've got the buckles there in a different color, so the belts in a different color. The sticks are black, and foot pedals there, foot pedals here, and anyway, so we're going to go and do that now, and then we'll show you what that looks like. Okay, so there it is. Just a way to figure out. Looks really good, actually. Be happy with that. And we're just leaving the back open still. I'm going to let all this dry here, let the glue dry. And when that's all dry, then we'll fix up the back end there. And then, of course, in the meantime, we've also finished this. So that's looking really good as well. It's got, including the instrument panels in there. That's looking pretty good. And it's, of course, also, silver on the inside. So that's getting ready to be put together. Okay, so we've just put together bits of the engine there as well, which is a whole bunch of pieces all stacked together here, and this one here still needs another coat of paint to get it nice and black. Anyway, that's enough for today. See ya. Okay, so basically this is a weekend's work. These two parts here are the two parts of the engine. That's the front, obviously, the 7-cylinder rotary engine. And you have to be very careful when you put this together down here that you don't get any glue anywhere where it shouldn't be, so that this thing can just turn like that. And here's the other part of the engine. You can see with the exhaust pipes there in brown, and the back side there. And yeah, these two parts fit together. They will go together, something like that, eventually. And then, of course, we have the frame here with the seats, and quite a lot of detail work in that. The console there. And, oh yeah, and of course, we also have, I think I might have mentioned this before, the top of the cockpits there. That's the back, and in the front we have the instrument panels there as well. Okay, so that's about it for now. Okay, so we just kind of skipped ahead here and put pretty much everything together. So you can see all that work that's gone into the inside carriage there is all inside there. And we've got the rubber bands holding things together while the glue is setting. Up the front here, we have that bit of a cage and the muffler, I guess, and exhaust. And yep, now we're going to put this piece down there, and this here is where the wings go. So I'm starting to put it all together, and then Layla's already put and cut out these pieces, which are the, I think they're called cowls or something. Anyway, they're the side bits that fit like around here. Okay. Looks pretty cool though. Especially in there. I don't know if you can see that. There's a stick there. Dashboard. Seats with seat belts. Anyway. Okay, so here we have this beautiful work of art now. Which has been... There's one coat of paint on that. I think we still need to do another one, but... The amount of detail that is hidden away inside that hole... is actually quite ridiculous. I don't know why we'd put all our effort into painting all those pieces when they're all hidden behind there, but anyway, we did. Looks pretty good though. So yeah, you can still see a bit of the yellow coming through like here in places. So yeah, we're still gonna have to put a second coat on that, but it looks pretty good. Okay, so we are now at the point of putting the decals on. There's one in there. So Layla is going to demonstrate now. I think that's ready. How we do this. Very clever. She's already pushed it half off. Now she puts it in position. Very good. And now... Alright, and then we just put it in the exact right position. Anyway, and we'll just keep doing that. We're making this one here. Okay, the day has come for final assembly. All the pieces are complete. Painted, decals are all on. So all we gotta do now is put it all together, which we will do now. Gluing the bottom wing on. We've already put the prop on. Okay, here we go. Here, you want to take over filming? That was easy. Cool. Okay, so we're just put the bottom wing together. We got the clips on there holding it together. Putting the final struts on. And there we go. And now just look at it from the front, Lela. And just make sure that they're all both exactly straight up and down. That one's leaning out a bit. Okay. And then we're just gonna let that dry for maybe half an hour or so, and then we'll put the top wing on. We've decided to do the tail section before the top wing. So Lela's just finishing applying the glue. We've already just glued that little tiny bit of silver piece on, which I believe is for moving the rudder. Anyway, and Lela's gonna put this piece on. Yep, that's it. Now don't push down on the wheel, lift the plane and then close that together and push it right down as hard as you can onto that surface. All right, look at it from the back, make sure it's level. Careful.
Yeah.
Good? Mm-hmm. Okay. Cool. That's that. And now the last piece, there you go, the rudder. Now I think that bracket is supposed to go into that little section that you cut out, yeah.
Okay, so I put glue in there.
Oh, I don't think you need to put glue in that. They'll just sit loosely in there. Don't even.
No, I'm just testing. Okay.
Yeah, all those surfaces. Okay. Cool. Now hopefully that'll just fit. So you probably have to, you'll work it out. Is it gonna do go?
No.
It's all right if you have to push it. Just try to get the top of the rudder in there.
I can't do it.
All right. You hold the film.
That piece of silver thing is too big. It's not going to fit in the hole.
Just dig.
What?
There we go. Are you able to just clean up the glue a little bit there? Okay, so we're ready to put the last piece on. Lela, could you please just gently take all the clips off?
Mm-hmm.
Try not to move them. That's it. Okay. Now, we have the wing here. The wing goes on top of sail. It's very easy. There's 8 holes to fill with glue. And I'm just going to turn the video off for this. And we'll be right back with the finished plane. Okay, so the wing is on. And it looks pretty good. So we've just got the rubber bands on there to hold everything in position. Just let that dry for probably an hour or two. And then we can take it off and it's finished. And Lela did a fantastic job. Come on, give us a thumbs up. Yay, 2 thumbs up, epic. Okay, so here is the finished product. Looking smashing. Yeah, pretty happy with it. Actually, very happy. Now, one thing we didn't do, and we've decided we're not gonna, is to put in all those, there's supposed to be a bunch of, like, lines, you know, kind of cross lines that go between the wings and also at the back here. That's just a little bit too fiddly, and we're not going to do that. We're just going to leave it as is. But yeah, so there's our finished model.